You won't get away with that.
Just say the word if you need a drink or something to eat.
My job is to serve the Jarl. I don't really know anyone at the college. I guess everyone just as... This should come in handy. Here, let me show you a few tricks I've learned about buttering up royalty. Safe travels.
Dagger allows him to stay there.
This is what it's come to. No one seems to care what they've done to our home.
I'd be a lot warmer and a lot happier with a belly full of meal.
My days at the college are long behind me, but I prefer to stay close by. So, you wish to master the arcane arts? Spells and incantations for those with the talent to cast them.
Even with the college's laid-back attitude, there are some experiments the college frowns on, if they're aware of them, of course.
Gesargo has heard of the Staff of Magnus. Once you are done with it, perhaps you will allow Gesargo and... Were they magnificent? No? It is true, Gesargo suspected there might be problems, but this is most disappointing. It is good that you are willing to help Gesargo. This will not be forgotten, friend. Then lead on, friend. Here? Right here. Very well. Gesargo shall wait.
Good to see Skyrim still has such fine people. You give an old man hope.
Gesargo has heard of the staff of Magnus. Gesargo is listening. What is it?
It's always encouraging to see the younger generations embracing education.
Did you require something of Gesargo?
We'll be waiting. The college will be here for you no matter what. We always look after our own.
Please don't bother the Archmage unless it's absolutely necessary.
If you are not here to grant me a good death, then you can leave. My time has come. I am old. Too old to become chief. It would be wrong for me to take wives at this age. So I will die. Malekith has given me a vision of a glorious death. I am to wait here until it finds me. As you can see, it has not yet arrived. Indeed, one should find his death while he can still call himself a proper man. We Orcmen are not like these Nords and Imperials who carry on until they are gray and feeble and their hair falls out. To cling to something past its usefulness is unseemly. How much more so when that thing is you? Yes. Were I to simply lay down and die, it would not please Malekith. Perhaps. Are you sure about this? We shall see.
You're mine! That it? Not your best? Everything all right?
Azura has seen your coming, traveler. It was not curiosity, but fate that has led you here. Azura has given me the gift of foresight. I had a vision of you walking up the steps to this altar, long before you were born. You have been chosen to be her champion. I know it is unexpected, but do not worry. It will all unfold as she has predicted. You must go to a fortress, endangered by water, yet untouched by it. Inside, you will find an elven mage who can turn the brightest star as black as night. It is cryptic, I know, but Azura's signs are never wrong. I believe the fortress may refer to Winterhold. Ask if they know this elven enchanter. Yes, there were others at first, but Azura's visions tested everyone's faith. One by one, they left, afraid to know the old future. But I refuse to abandon the shrine. The visions are a gift. Azura warns me of tragedy, war, death, before it happens. I won't leave her guidance. My people, the Dunmer, built it. We fled from Morrowind after Vardenfell erupted, almost 200 years ago. Those of us who were faithful to Azura were given a vision that led us away from the island before the worst came. This shrine is our thanks to her, that none will forget that she watches over us all. She is the goddess of dawn and dusk. Azura sees into the twilight of the future and guides her followers through it. This has all been foreseen, and we must play our parts.
Disrespect the law, and you disrespect me.
Stay out of trouble, Argonian.
Thank you.
Please don't bother the Archmage unless it's absolute. If there are any problems, let me know. It's my job to keep things running smoothly. An elf that studies stars? Where did you hear about that? No, I wouldn't. Why don't you head into town and get a drink at the Frozen Hearth? I hear old Nelikar still has a room there. He knows a lot of stories, that one. Well, now that's an odd question. Why in the world would you be asking? I see. Well, yes, I suppose I did mention it. Though I'm not sure what he expects me to tell you. I only brought it to his attention a few months back when the Synod showed up here looking for it. They were apparently under the impression we were keeping it in a closet somewhere. Mages based out of Cyrodiil. They fancy themselves the Imperial Authority on magic these last few hundred years. My understanding is that all they really do is make noise in an attempt to curry favor from the Emperor. Lots of politics, little magic. I was quite surprised to find them on our doorstep. They seemed amiable enough, but their line of questioning made me uneasy. It became clear they're trying to hoard powerful artifacts, looking to consolidate power. No one here does. The Synod seemed convinced it was somewhere in Skyrim. They inquired about the ruins of M'Zulft, but that's all I remember. It sounded like they were heading there, though they were rather secretive about why. I suppose if you're intent on looking for the staff, there's a chance they might be in M'Zulft yet. Just don't expect them to be cooperative. I'm not really sure. Made and used by Magnus himself, if you believe those sorts of things. I believe I've heard it said that it's the only thing that could adequately contain his power. The sort of embellishment wizards of ancient times loved to make. There are no expectations. This college is a place to study and practice magic freely. Hopefully any discoveries made in your pursuits will be shared with the members of the college first. That way we all benefit. Well, that depends on what you're looking for. Feralda can teach destruction spells, and offers training in that school. Finis is one of the best conjurers in all of Skyrim, and can help with spells from that school. Don't let Tulfdir fool you. He's the preeminent scholar on alteration. One of the best in Tamriel, and always willing to pass on his knowledge. If you can find him and focus his attention, there's a great deal Drevis can teach you about illusion magic. And finally, there's Colette. She may be difficult to get along with. She's very knowledgeable when it comes to restoration magic. No more than anyone else, I don't think. They're a very old order, predated the Imperial Mages Guild by quite a bit. In fact, the Mages Guild was founded in opposition to the idea of the Psijic Order, that only an elite few should have control over magic. No one has seen or heard from them in over 100 years now, though. Have you managed to track down the Synod, or the staff of Magnus?
I'm working on some very important research, I assure you.
My favorite drinking buddy. Let's get some mead.
My days at the college are long behind me, but I prefer to stay close by. Who sent you? Was it the college? The Jarl? We agreed there would be no more questions. You're working with the Daedra? Right. Now tell me the one about the Argonian maid and the lusty baron. A few coins for my soul. If only you understood the irony. What do you know about soul gems? That's what caused all the trouble. Soul gems are used in enchanting, but they break afterwards. Except one. Azura's Star, a Daedric artifact that allows any number of souls to pass through it. Some of us wanted to find out how. I was working under Malin Varan then. If only we knew what he was really planning. Malin wanted to alter the star. He was dying, disease. He thought he could store his own soul inside, become immortal. It drove him mad. Students started dying. Eventually, the college exiled him. He took a few loyal disciples to Illyn Alter's Deep and vanished. Look, I don't care who asked you to find the star, but don't take it back to Azura. The Daedra are evil. They're the reason Malin went insane. Azura is no ordinary Daedra. She commands an entire realm inside of Oblivion. The more Malin worked on the star, the more she was able to damn him. It started slowly at first. Malin would see things that weren't there. Then he would yell at students over words they hadn't said. Then one day I walked in and Malin had killed a student, and in a horrific moment of inspiration, he started using her soul for his work. The college would agree with you. But do you have any idea how many innocent lives were cut short just so Azura could have revenge? We're nothing to the Daedra. Pawns to move around, praise and punish as they see fit. I mentioned how the star is a soul gem, only it never gets depleted. There's another rule the artifact follows. You can only store white souls in the star belonging to the lesser creatures. Azura's magic won't allow black souls to enter it. As a mortal, Malin's soul was black, so part of his work was breaking past Azura's rules. He was close before. Well, I already told you. I mentioned how the star is a soul gem, only it never gets depleted. There's another rule the artifact follows.
thralls of yours are slower than Argonians in a blizzard.
Feel free to grab a pick and help them out. I prefer not to sully myself with manual labor.
There goes another one.
Bah, weak-willed rabble. Even dead, they're almost useless.
They seem less intelligent each time you raise them, if that's even possible.
As long as they can swing a pickaxe where I tell them, they're as smart as we need them to be.
You hear that? The others must have found something.
We'd better go see. These can tend to themselves for a few minutes.
Thralls of yours are slower than Argonian. In a blizzard.
Feel free to grab a pick and help them out. I prefer not to sully myself with manual labor.
There goes another one.
Bah, weak-willed rabble. Even dead, they're almost useless.
They seem less intelligent each time you raise them, if that's even possible.
As long as they can swing a pickaxe where I tell them, they're as smart as we need them to be.
You hear that? The others must have found something.
We'd better go see. These can tend to themselves for a few minutes.
If I can just stand up.
yourselves a hero.
Care of that?
Pick up your trash, Fetcher.
Never should have come here.
Damn you!
Enough!
I'm spoken for, you know, so don't get any ideas.
Feyndahl thinks he can woo Camilla Valerius away from me. She's already mine, I keep...
You're that visitor been poking around. Sure thing. It's yours for a day.
You look like a traveler. Someone that has seen faraway places and heard new stories.
I'm the innkeeper. It's my business to keep track of strangers.
We got rooms and food. Drink, too. I cook. Ain't much else to tell. Need a room? Talk to Delphine.
You're that visitor, Ben. I'm the innkeeper. Oh, you wanted the attic room. Why didn't you say so the first time? The thing is, we don't actually have an attic room. But I think I know what you mean. Go ahead and make yourself at home. So you're the Dragonborn I've been hearing so much about. I think you're looking for this. We need to talk. Follow me. Now we can talk. The Greybeards seem to think you're the Dragonborn. I hope they're right. Surprised? I guess I'm getting pretty good at my harmless innkeeper act. You can't be too careful. Thalmor spies are everywhere. I didn't go to all this trouble on a whim. I needed to make sure it wasn't a Thalmor trap. I am not your enemy. I already gave you the horn. I'm actually trying to help you. I just need you to hear me out. Like I said in my note, I've heard that you might be Dragonborn. I'm part of a group that's been looking for you. Well, someone like you, for a very long time. If you really are Dragonborn, that is. Before I tell you any more, I need to make sure I can trust you. I knew the Greybeards would send you there if they thought you were Dragonborn. They're nothing if not predictable. When you showed up here, I knew you were the one the Greybeards sent, and not some Thalmor plant. Yes, we're very old enemies. And if my suspicions are correct, they might have something to do with the dragons returning. But that isn't important right now. What is important is that you might be Dragonborn. We remember what most don't, that the Dragonborn is the ultimate dragon slayer. You're the only one that can kill a dragon permanently by devouring its soul. Can you do it? Can you devour a dragon's soul? This is no time to play the reluctant hero. You either are or aren't Dragonborn. But I'll see for myself soon enough. We remember what most don't, that the Dragonborn is the ultimate dragon slayer. You're the only one that can kill a dragon permanently by devouring its soul. Dragons aren't just coming back. They're coming back to life. They weren't gone somewhere for all these years. They were dead, killed off centuries ago by my predecessors. Now something's happening to bring them back to life, and I need you to help me stop it. I know they are. I visited their ancient burial mounds and found them empty. And I figured out where the next one will come back to life. We're going to go there, and you're going to kill that dragon. If we succeed, I'll tell you anything you want to know. You should know. You got the map for me. The Dragonstone you got for Farengar, remember? So you were paying attention. I arranged to have Farengar recover the Dragonstone for me. It's what I do. I make things happen from behind the scenes. After all, here you are. Yes, a map of ancient dragon burial sites. I've looked at which ones are now empty. The pattern is pretty clear. It seems to be spreading from the southeast, starting in the Geralds near Riften. The one near Kynesgrove is next, if the pattern holds. Kynesgrove. There's an ancient dragon burial near there. If we can get there before it happens, maybe we'll learn how to stop it. I need to get into my traveling gear. Give me a minute and I'll be ready. That's better. Let's get on the road to Kynesgrove.